Welcome back to another video of Lately Customs. Today we're working on the yellow thing once again, and we are attempting a very difficult job and a very crap job. So the job I'll be attempting today is trying to remove the timing belt seal. It's a very difficult seal to replace because you have to remove all the pulleys and the pulley that's on for the timing belt. And that's a very difficult job because I really like two or three bolts already spoiled and I didn't even touch it yet. So someone already tried to replace it previously and actually spoiled the bolts. And there was one bolt that was really loose. I'm gonna try and attempt to actually loosen this up just to get that seal out and replace because I already bought the seal. But I'm really not sure how far I'm gonna get or if I'm even gonna achieve this today. But it's worth a try and we can see how far we actually get. On today's mission to do this job, we'll be needing to get the timing in properly, so we have to get all the pulleys on the marks. I already got the flywheel there, you can see right there. I already got it on its mark. Then you have to check if the number one piston is on top. Then you have to check if your crank pulley is on top, and if you check if your cam pulley is lined up perfectly here, right around there, with the valve cover. So I got everything lined up. I did that before I actually started the video. Now I can actually start loosening everything. But the first thing you want to do is actually just to loosen your alternator, just to push it a little bit back, and then you can actually remove this fan belt right here, because you will have to remove this pulley right there, this pulley right here, and the leakage is behind this pulley right here, because as you can see right there, if you can see properly, but that seal right there keeps on popping out. Even though I press it back in there, I push it a little bit deeper in. See, right there, it's moving. So it pops out each time. And that's the reason why it's leaking, because I keep on popping it in. And then after a drive or hour's drive, and it just pops out once again and starts turning with the pulley. And the only way to actually get that perfectly in is to actually just remove the pulley and to replace that seal one time. But this is going to be a very difficult job, because I need to remove all the Allen keys right there at the bottom. But the first thing I'm going to try to do is maybe to remove that 90 nut right there. Maybe if I remove the nut, then everything after that will actually just come off. So what I'm going to try to do is I'm going to try to lock up this entire system right here. I'm going to try my own method actually just to lock it up. But before I do that, I'm just going to loosen the alternator a little bit just to get this belt off right quick. So what you need to do to loosen up the alternator, I need to loosen this nut and bolt right here, and then here at the bottom right here we have an Allen key. So you loosen that up right there, and then you can just push back the alternator, which I'm going to show you guys right now. If you check right there, I actually loosen this nut and bolt up right here, and I loosen this Allen key bolt right there. So you guys can see I can just easily remove the belt. So now we have the belt off. This belt still seems right, to be honest. Seems like a kind of new belt. I think I still have a belt right there, but I think that belt I have right there is in a little bit of better condition than that one. But now, you guys can see right there, I have absolutely no idea how I'm gonna actually come to replace that seal. I'm literally just trying my utmost best. I'm gonna see what I can do to actually get that pulley off. I was maybe thinking of just maybe if I could just maybe get one pulley off, maybe I could, maybe just this pulley right here, and maybe I'll eventually get that pulley. But I'm gonna see how far I get, and I'm gonna see if I actually can achieve it. But fingers crossed, and see how far we get.
Many minutes later,
what I managed to do is I managed to get the timing pulley loosened up. So what I did was I just pressed in the screwdriver. Here's a small cap right here where you can actually press in the screwdriver. Took in the screwdriver, took a 19mm spanner, and just put it on there, and then I just lifted it up, and now it's actually loosened up. It's still very tight though, but it is loosened up. So I'm maybe gonna try to get the bottom one as well, the one there at the bottom right there. If I can actually manage to get the crank pulley one loosened up as well, and it will be a very great achievement. But the problem I'm having right now is that I think that Allen keys are actually tightened up to the other pulley inside that actually runs on the cam belt. And that's the only problem I'm having at the moment, because I saw a video But you have to remove the Allen keys. One of the Allen keys is already loosened up. Guys can see that one right there. That's standing out a little to the other three. So I need to get the other three loosened up as well. And two of those are already spoiled. So I have no idea what I'm going to do. But I'm going to try my utmost best not to spoil it further. Which I think I actually am going to do. But let's see how far we get. Just a small recap to give you guys a little heads up on what I've been up to these, it's like a past hour and a half. So what I did was, to get the crank nut, or this crank bolt loosened, you need to, it's more known as the rope method. So what you do is that, I know the screwdriver most probably just ruined the piston a little, but what you do, you just put something like, usually like a nice thick rope would do the trick. You just put the rope in here, and when he's busy with the upward stroke, then at that time, you just put a 19 spanner or 19 socket with your power bar, whatever, on here. And you loosen up the bolt on the crank pulley. Because that way, I don't need to loosen the four Allen keys, which the other three is already spoiled. And how I loosen this pulley up is that this is no more known as the water pump. So, what I did is that I just loosen, I think it's like 2, 4, 6, 8. It's 8 nuts that keep the water pump in place. So this way I don't need to spoil any of the Allen keys, because they are very, very fragile. And this way was the best way and the safest way for me to actually do this. So I hope this actually helps you a lot. So like I said, just make sure when you're removing everything that everything is TDC, meaning it is on top, like everything is top dead center. That's what TDC means. So make sure everything is top dead center, your pulley, your flywheel, your crank, everything is on the dot, because after the installation of that seal, we will need to restore this car's timing, which I'm gonna do once again after everything is replaced. Let me just get everything removed and I'll show you guys how to replace that cam seal right there. Obviously, when using this method, you have to remove your number one spark plug, which I already did. It's laying right there, and to be honest, the car is overfueling because of the cam in the car. But if any of you guys want a 272 cam, and you guys have a standard cam, you guys are more than willing to swap me for an 8-valve carburetor 1.8. If you guys have a standard cam, we can do a swap, because you can just offer me a slight cash difference, because I really want normal fuel consumption on this car every day, because this car is quite heavy in fuel. But I think if I just adjust the carburetor and everything else, the car will be perfectly fine, but I would rather choose to have the standard cam in the car. But like you guys can see right here, I got every single thing removed. And when I removed this pulley right here, like, it literally, like, everything just, like, poop, it popped off. Even though the cam seal, here's the cam seal right here. So what I did was, is that I don't want everything to be a epic fail. So I just bought a Goldwagen cam seal, because it's rather to buy a quality cam seal than one of those Chinatown cam seals. So now that I know that cam seal will be replaced like this, everything will be perfectly fine, top of the oil, and the car will be stroopsoet, is the right word. But note, there's no way on effing this up. Just note that there's a groove in this pulley right here. I don't know if you guys can see that groove. So when you put this pulley back on its place, or just put the pulley back, just note that groove will have to be on the same place where that little pin is sticking out right there. On that timing, yeah, I don't know what you call that, but it has to be on there. And then when you get your crank timing in as well, it has a groove right there as well. So I just put it on the groove once again, and everything will be perfectly fine. Just note, before putting all this back, you will have to unfortunately put the cam belt back on. I got a way to remove the cam belt without removing any of these. And the other thing is, because I removed the water pump, unfortunately, all the water was drained out of the system. So I'll need to throw water back in the system. But on a later stage, I'm going to put antifreeze in here, as well as in the Honda. But now, let's get to the cam seal part. How do you replace your cam seal on the car? This is just the first part of the installation. You need to remove everything. Put in the cam seal, and then you have to put all this back once again. And that's the crappy part. But I'm going to get the cam seal quick, and you guys can actually see how I do the installation on this cam seal on this car. While busy with this job, I actually realized that I'll be needing a new gasket for this water pump. So Like, Phrygis arrived here, and I mean, like, he was just like someone seen from the gods, like the Carthusian gods, and he just like arrived here. And I was like, damn, bro, I really need this casket, and I really had no idea how I'm gonna get it. So I just gave my card team, and he's gonna go buy me a casket real quick. But while he's gone, I actually got the seal removed out of the package. So this is the one I bought at Goldwagen. It's the cargo. I don't know how to pronounce that, but this is the seal. Is this one right here? Report. I paid 50 rand for it at Goldwagen. So, like, parts like this will like cost you like 10 rand, 12 rand, 15 rand, 20 rand at your local spare shop. But, like, especially seals.
Got it!
Seals. You need to buy at a proper place, which I recommend, Goldwagen. Because, okay, I already bought the first cam seal at Sunday Space, I think. But I bought me this seal at Goldwagen because I was at Goldwagen that day. And you can actually feel, look here, but if you check it like this, look how nice and flexible that is. But if you check the old seal, which is not too bad, but it's like, you see, it's very, very stiff. I have to apply a lot of pressure to actually get it to where it's supposed to be. But I'm just going to heat the seal in. And then it will be properly sealed. So what you need to do is that whenever you heat the seal in to its proper place, you need to get a proper socket. So you need to get the socket the right size of the seal, which is a 32. 32 is still a little bit too small, but I'll check for... If you actually got a 33 or a 34 millimeter socket, it will work perfectly fine because I think that's the diameter of this one. But I'm just going to put that one in there. So I'm just going to dry off some of the oil right there. That's where the seal actually goes in. Or it's supposed to be situated. So I'm just going to take a nice normal lappy. And just dry it off. I actually wanted to spray some of the pulleys and make it look nice. But because it's still very, very oily here and there's oil everywhere, I thought, look, yeah, I'm going to do that on another day. Gonna first have to respray or spray out the entire motor, clean up the motor and just make it look fresh, and then after that you can actually move on to doing all that. But for now, that's the way to go. So just need to get the seal in there. It has to be nice and tight. And it's not actually, check it from there, it's not actually a black seal, it's actually grey. So definitely recommend the seal, and pick up the Goldwagen for actually providing me with the seal. So thankful. But let's get it in right there quick. So what I'm going to do right there, I'm just going to put it in like that. There we go. So I'm just going to put it in there. Well, I'm just going to let it rest there. Then I'm just going to put the phone down real quick. I'm going to try to get it up on an angle. And actually show you guys how to actually heat it up. So whenever you're heating in the seal, just make sure, like I said, you're using the exact same socket. What I do is I use this bend, I don't know what you call this, bending socket thing. So I just use it from the bottom like this, put it over the hole, and then I just hammer it from the back right here with the hammer. And when you're done heating it in, just make sure it's flush with the block of the motor. But checking for that, now I know, look at that one, is completely fine and it's stiff and it is right. Then I checked out this seal right here, and this one is, I don't know if you can see right there, it's actually moving. So what I was thinking of, look here, I'm going to replace the seal. While Fred is down there, I told him, look here, I could buy me a seal for the crank as well. So he's going to buy me a seal for the crank, so I know all three seals is then perfectly fine. Like you can see, I'm not sure if it's leaking out here, but it seems like it will be. It's actually leaking out here, as well as by this one right there. So when both seals are replaced, I'm sure that the leak on this car will be completely sorted out, because it was only leaking by the seals. And by this age of this motor, I'm sure that these seals needed a replacement. And I think when they rebuilt the motor, this motor has been overhauled. So when they overhauled the motor, I think I didn't replace the seals, or this was just probably the old seals or crack or crap seals or second-hand seals, but that is not the way you do it. And when I asked Fred to actually go buy me the gasket for this, they told me you don't actually get a gasket, but I think they mentioned like a new gasket is like 250 rand. But then a guy told me, look here bro, I'll do you a favor and I'll just trace it out for you and I'll give you the material, everything, and then I can just cut it out on a normal piece of rubber which is provided by Sonder Space as well. So guys, a big thanks to that. It's working out way cheaper and it's the exact same thing. So I'm gonna do that. I'm just waiting for Fred and I'm gonna trace it out. And then this one right here, I'm gonna try and remove the seal right here, which I think it will be fairly easy. You just put in the screwdriver like that right there, and you just kinda like pop it out. Very difficult to do, but it is coming out, and there we go. There we go. We got that seal removed. You guys can see that seal was very slippy and it's supposed to be very tight in that hole right there. But now I can one time replace both seals because the seal is also very hard and it's supposed to sit very tight. It's not supposed to be like in and out like this. Like I know when I tried to get in the top seal right there, it was very tight and I actually struggled to get it in. And I remember the top seal by the cam as well, I struggled to get that one in as well. So this one is the same principle supply. It's supposed to be very tight and this one is so not tight. So now if all the seals are replaced, then we know we're good to go. I got both pulleys respread. I got the pulley respread and I got the pulley on the water pump respread as well. I got this pulley respread and I got the cam pulley respread. So everything will be looking a little bit neat and I got that pulley respread ready. So I'm just gonna do the installation right now and I'll update you guys as soon as I'm done.
A few moments later,
I got the water pump back on, I got the crank pulley back on and I got them tightened up. Unfortunately I don't have a torque wrench so I couldn't torque them up to the correct spec, but I tightened them up as much as I could, so we know that is tight. I got this pulley back on, I got that tightened up, I got all the bolts tightened up on the water pump. I know there's one spilled which there was only 18, but there's like 9 holes. So what I did with the gasket on the water pump, you get like a piece of paper which is laying right here, and they literally just graft out the gasket type, yeah, the gasket, what you call it, design, and you just literally need to cut it out, and that's why the grooves aren't like flush with the water pump. So now that we have everything in, I actually have one of these 8mm tensioners. So the original tensioner is still completely fine, but because I already have like a brand new tensioner, I can just one time put on the new tensioner. But the only thing is, this one right here, that's 10mm and this one is 8mm, but it seems to still fit. So I'm gonna one time use the 8mm because it's a brand new tensioner, and just to give the car that new effect on the side, because yeah, I respect all the pulleys, so this thing will be brand new as well. So I'm gonna put this one on. So this tensioner comes on right here. Oh, let me just put it on. Oh shit, it comes on right there. Oh fuck, there we go. So there's where the tension actually goes on. So just note, when you come to this process, you have to put everything on its mark once again. So we need to get the camshaft on its mark, we need to get the crank put on its mark, we need to get the flywheel on its mark, and as soon as everything is on its mark, then we can start tightening up the tensioner and make sure the belt is stiff enough, and then we set the distributor timing right after that. So let's get started.
2,000 years later.
Ha ha ha!
it's like at least a few hours later, and I think it's like 4 or 3 hours later. I've been struggling with the timing the entire time with the car because for some reason the car, it started off the first time and then I just tuned the timing a little bit and then I gave a burnout, which you guys just saw in the video, yeah, before this, the clip before this. But then the car did what it did in the video. And then taking it for another test drive, the car just got worse and worse. And then I've been struggling with the timing ever since. Then I started completely over. I started like over like a few times, a few teams. I failed. Then last time I was looking, I'm going to do it again. I put it on the 6th degree before TDC mark. And I put the mark of the... I put it on 6 degrees before TDC on the flywheel. I put the timing mark on the cam pulley, just below the valve cover, where the valve cover starts. And then the crank is obviously on top and the piston is obviously on top. So I set the timing in perfectly, I think, but it doesn't pull as leaky as the beginning. But the car is still leaking oil, and I actually checked, it's actually leaking oil by the sump plug this time and by the valve cover. So it will be needing a new valve cover gasket as well as a sump plug. So I'm definitely going to invest in that in the future. I think I'm going to rather just use, I don't know if you're familiar with that white, like plastic kind of rubberish wire you use for the plumbing pipes. I'm going to do that around by the sump plug and maybe put a little bit of sealant around there. And then I really put sealant around the previous time on the valve cover, but then I think the last time I removed it, I actually just sealed it up and I didn't seal it up properly enough. So I'm just one time going to buy a new gasket for the valve cover. It's the best way and it's the right way. So I hope you guys enjoyed today's video. I'm really, really sorry that I didn't show too much. I just got like super, super tired and it's like super dark. It's like around like, it's like 11:30 right now. So to think about it, the last time I actually saw you guys was when it was still a little bit light up. So now, yeah, but just know the car is completely right, and I really explained to you guys everything when it comes to replacing the seal. So I replaced the crank seal and replaced the timing cam seal, yeah. But now I think the cam seal might still be leaking for some reason, I have no idea why, but yeah, I definitely need to check it out tomorrow morning. But I did clean it up, I resprayed the pulleys, I resprayed the water pump, I respect everything, so it looks kind of nicer on the side. But the engine still needs a clean though, so I still need to display the clean out the whole engine. But like I said, I hope you guys enjoyed today's video. Please do subscribe to my channel and please do like this video. I'll really be grateful if you guys really like this video, because the likes and the comments and the subscription, it everything helps me so much. And please do click that bell, because whenever you click the bell, it sends a notification to your phone whenever I'm uploading new content. So that way you stay updated by simply just watching my videos. And please guys, please do buy my merch. Like I said, the t-shirts are 180 Rand, the caps are 160, the hoodies are 450. I'm still going to try and invest in a hoodie for myself, because I haven't bought a hoodie for myself yet. And then my maroon t-shirt is still coming, and then the cap is still coming. So I'm going to show you guys the cap soon. I'm meeting up with Carl tomorrow for the cap. So I'm going to get the cap and I'm going to show you guys the cap tomorrow. I think if I'm getting the cap tomorrow, I'll definitely show you guys the cap tomorrow. But yeah, everything is going well. So peace out. And remember, you guys will always remember, stop racing. I wouldn't say go stop speed, but stop racing and go stance.